Welcome to Team Pegine's Motivational Message for Leaders and Entrepreneurs. Pegine Echevarria is founder of Team Pegine, a multifaceted human potential company that focuses on leadership, success, and team building. Listen as she shares her thoughts on how enthusiasm creates results.
Hi, this is Pegine, and I am so glad to be able to share with you about a topic that is very near and dear to my heart. It's something that I know each and every day in my life, being enthusiastic has definitely transformed where I am and where I'm going. And I hope that my experiences and the knowledge that I've created about enthusiasm can help you have the results that you want, help you create the business and the career that you've dreamt of, and more importantly, that surrounding you in every aspect of your life, that you have the results you deserve and that I want you to have. This program is about the fact that enthusiasm does create results. During this CD, you'll hear about why enthusiasm is important, why enthusiasm is the emotion that people choose not to experience and share, how enthusiasm creates results in your life, how you can be enthusiastic, and most importantly, the steps that you can avoid to losing your enthusiasm. So I'm ready to go on, and I hope that you're ready to join me about how enthusiasm creates results in your life. All right, so why is enthusiasm important? Enthusiasm is important because it enables you to break through the boredom of your daily to-do list. I mean, life can get boring, and enthusiasm, well, just energizes you. People love being around enthusiastic people. I mean, really, think about the people that are enthusiastic in your life. Do you perceive them as being passionate and persistent and dedicated? Do you see them as living life to its fullest? And really, wouldn't you love people to think about you in that way? A business person who exudes enthusiasm is more likely to draw in customers. GM believes so strongly about enthusiasm that it's made enthusiasm one of its core values. Enthusiasm creates energy, which in turn creates opportunities. Enthusiasm signifies to people around you, to the world around you, that you have confidence. Enthusiasm is healthy. We already have heard how negative attitudes and negativity can make us sick. Well, if enthusiasm is good, why do people not experience enthusiasm? I mean, why do they choose not to experience and not to share enthusiasm? I think that one of the things that I found in my research about enthusiasm that struck me as true was when I looked at how enthusiasm, the word, was created. Let's look at the root of enthusiasm. It comes from two Latin and Greek words, and part of my Greek and part of my Latin in terms of pronunciation. One is enhousiazen, which means to be inspired by a god. The other word, entheos, which means possessed. See, for us to feel enthusiasm, we are truly acknowledging that we are being inspired by God, or by a God, your God. You know, in reality, humans, for us, I mean, that is way too much responsibility. It's too lofty. And most of us, most people who aren't enthusiastic, think they just aren't ready to be inspired. If you knew that you were being inspired by a higher power, if you were being inspired by the universe, it means that you have to take action. And to take action to move on that confronts us with some of our fears. This is where fears appear big time. What kind of fears are we talking about? Well, how about the fear of disappointment? If you're enthusiastic about a project, if you're enthusiastic about something happening in your life, and you're there, and you don't get it, oh my goodness, boom, the drop that you'll experience. So our fear of being disappointment, the fear of the pain of not getting it, makes us avoid being enthusiastic about something. The fear of lying and misleading people. Ooh, if I'm enthusiastic about something and I'm sharing it, I'll make it bigger than it really is, and then people will think that I'm lying about it, and they won't really like me. They'll think that I'm misleading them. Maybe you're not. Why do we choose to pick up that fear? You should be enthusiastic about good things happening in your life. You should be just jumping for joy. How about the fear of embarrassment? What will people think of me if the project or the raise doesn't happen? What will people perceive about me? I couldn't show myself in public. So we choose not to be enthusiastic because, well, what will people think of me? The second word, which signified being possessed, brings to mind one of the major fears most everyone has. Have you ever walked down the street and you've seen somebody that's homeless or somebody that's suffering a mental illness, and they're talking to themselves and they're babbling away? Well, we all look at them and we think thoughts. We all are afraid to go near them or fear that what will they do to us? Well, this word about being possessed stops us from sharing our enthusiasm because we really are afraid that people will think we're possessed. I mean, usually people don't walk around being enthusiastic. So if you are enthusiastic and you're different than the norm, then our fear of rejection plays on us. Because we know that our family members, our friends, our coworkers, and others may not share our enthusiasm. We also have to know that we've learned some of these fears from our biggest mentors, the television, the newspaper, and the media. I mean, think about it. They've communicated time and again that enthusiasm can, although not always, make people look silly and ridiculous. Think about some of the game shows when somebody's winning and they're so excited and they scream and they shake themselves and they look, well, ridiculous. We don't want people to see us look that way. Or that if we see someone acting flamboyant and enthusiastic, well, we actually think that that's what we'll look like, and we're laughing at them, so won't others laugh at us? Interestingly, you can't reach the media, you can't have your TV show, the newspapers don't want to interview you, and people don't want to know about you unless you are enthusiastic. I mean, we want to see enthusiasm in our movie stars, with our TV shows, in our politicians, and in the press. But we aren't quite sure that we want to spend the energy on being enthusiastic in our own lives. We actually would choose to be not enthusiastic and not noticed and not have the business and the results that we could have and should have. Which leads us to, how does enthusiasm create results? So how does enthusiasm create results? Well, here are some ways that it does. Enthusiastic people are rewarded. I mean, enthusiastic people reap rewards. They are the ones that are noticed for opportunities, whether it's in relationships, employment, leadership, or awards. They're noticed. Enthusiastic people have strong disease prevention traits. They don't get sick. Enthusiasm is the most powerful emotion for disease prevention. Quantum physics introduced, in its simplest form, the concept that everything is made of energy. It's been found that energy can be measured. The latest technology in the health arena is called vibrational medicine, which measures a person's energy frequency and studies the effects on their health and disease. As described by Robert Tennyson Stevens in the Harmonic Scale of Emotion, and I quote, "The highest frequency emotion is enthusiasm. Love and joy also fall into this category. This is followed by pain, emotional or physical, which is followed by anger. The next lower frequency emotion is fear, which is followed by grief. Below grief is apathy. Finally, the lowest frequency emotion is unconsciousness, meaning it is so awful that we have completely blocked out those situations from our lives." He continues, "If we're experiencing anything less than enthusiasm in any area of our life, we have lowered our frequency and are running the risk of disease. In order to be healthy, people must increase their frequency." End quote. So, if you want to be proactive about your health, be enthusiastic. Enthusiastic people feel great. I mean, it really feels great. There's nothing quite as exhilarating being and smiling broadly and involving others with glee. The feeling of warmth and life is, well, it's hard to explain. You just feel it when you feel enthusiastic. Enthusiastic people, well, they exude love, and more love. When you're enthusiastic, you receive love. Why, we enjoy being around enthusiastic people. They bring us in, embrace us, and we feel connected. The emotion is even more powerful the person who is enthusiastic. We feel it even more powerfully than you who are hanging around with us. Enthusiastic people feel your love, your energy, and your connection to them. The energy level raises and everyone is feeling great. I mean, you feel giddy and happy and full of joy. You smile and create even more energy around you, feeling even more terrific. You feel magical, as though the whole world is supporting your dream. Enthusiastic people break barriers. They see life as full of opportunities. Rather than seeing barriers, they see opportunities to grow and make positive choices. They see alternatives to get around those barriers. Enthusiastic people are charismatic. People are attracted to you. They're attracted to enthusiastic people. They want to know the secret, their secret to life. They want to follow enthusiastic people, hoping the enthusiasm rubs off. Business people want to be connected to enthusiastic people because they're usually hanging around other successful people. Enthusiastic people just make things happen. Enthusiastic people are happy to share opportunities. Enthusiastic people believe that the world is full and abundant. They want others to share in the delight and often want others to participate in opportunities. Caution. And I mean caution. Enthusiastic people move away quickly when somebody is negative or an energy drain. If enthusiastic people move away from you, change your behavior. They're not likely to hang out with you for long. Enthusiastic people are invited to events. Successful events, parties, gatherings want enthusiastic people. Without them, the party can be, well, dull. Enthusiastic people create energy, positive power, and delight. Enthusiastic people create momentum. Their enthusiasm builds powerful energies around them for projects, ideas, and proposals. They create the propulsion to have things looked at, evaluated, and to have them succeed. Enthusiastic people are persistent. They keep on opening doors even when they close. They just keep on going because they're so enthusiastic. They're willing to take the risks to have the results. If they hear no, they find new ways to yes. It's why top salespeople rate very high in enthusiasm. Enthusiastic people take responsibility for their enthusiasm. They know that their enthusiasm for a project is critical to having positive results. All right, so we know that enthusiastic people create results, but how can you be enthusiastic? Get ready, get set, and let's go. here's how you can be enthusiastic. I've outlined some steps that you can take, starting right now, this moment, that can make you more enthusiastic. First, smile. You create enthusiasm by starting with a smile. When you're by yourself, smile. Come on, do it right now. You're by yourself. There isn't anything you need to do. Just smile. Look at yourself when you smile. Answer the phone, smiling, especially when you don't feel like doing it. Smile when you go outside. Smile at the people walking down the street. Here's a hard one. Smile at your husband or wife or children. Smile when you walk into a meeting or an event. Smile if you feel totally silly or shy, embarrassed, or that you're lying. After you do this, identify the results of your smile. Really look at it. How are people responding to you? What effect are you having on your telephone calls because you're smiling? And how are you feeling because you're smiling? The next thing you can do is to laugh. I mean, not just the hee-hee-hee-hee laugh, but a really loud, hard, belly-hurting laugh. Now, I know for some of you, this can be a challenge. We're so used to just going hee-hee or just giving a little smirk instead of actually laughing. Listen to my laugh as I laugh for 15 seconds. Listen, because you'll be doing it also. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Did that hurt? Now, let's do it together. When I say three, we're all gonna laugh together. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Identify the results of your laugh. How do you feel? When was the last time you had a great big belly laugh like that? What's your attitude now? Terrific. Compliment people. When you meet someone, look at positive attributes for a little bit,
or that you just met,
special about them.
Look for something.
Maybe the color they're wearing. Their smile, their eyes, the presentation that they made, or the question that they asked. Tell them with really genuine appreciation. Think about it. Don't you like to hear when somebody compliments you? Don't you feel good when you hear that? And then you want to make that person feel better? I'm not talking about making something up that's not true. I mean focusing truly on the person you're communicating with, seeing something about them that looks good, feels good, that you can relate with, and then sharing that with them. As you do that, you begin to feel more enthusiastic because you're reaching out to someone else. Acknowledge your own accomplishments and that of your department. One of the things that enthusiastic people do is they acknowledge themselves for the steps that they've taken and also acknowledge those people around them, maybe their department, maybe their staff, maybe even their boss, and they acknowledge what good has occurred. They write it or say it out loud, and if you are right now driving or wherever you are right now listening, you need to come up with 5 accomplishments that you and your department, you and your staff, you and your company have had. Think of 5 that you had this week, today, within the last month. And I don't want to hear that you can't say that you haven't had any. If you are so deep in negativity, here are five accomplishments. I'm so upset that I had to say it that way. Because if you're thinking that you're negative and that there's nothing good, I need you to know that here are five that you can use. One is, you got up today. Woohoo! Two, you're listening to the CD and you're learning. Three, you're breathing. Four, you know you need to be enthusiastic and you're learning about it right now. Five, you had a great laugh just a few seconds ago. And for those of you that didn't do it, go back and laugh. Or at the very least, smile. I know it's impossible to be enthusiastic every minute of the day. However, you have to be vigilant or else you'll lose your enthusiasm altogether. Professional, enthusiastic people, and I mean that they take their enthusiasm seriously, know that there are certain steps that they must avoid, or else they'll lose their enthusiasm. Get ready to hear the steps to avoid losing your enthusiasm. Here are steps to avoid losing your enthusiasm. You see, enthusiasm needs to be nurtured and supported. You can lose your enthusiasm like this if you encounter the following pitfalls. The first is keeping away from negative people with negative energy. Often enthusiastic people attract people who are negative. I mean, their negative people are attracted to you because you have what they want and believe that they will never have. You have to be aware that often negative people really don't want to change. They just like hanging on and to prove that their way is right and your way is wrong. They want you to stop being so enthusiastic, and they will be there to try to drain you from your enthusiasm. If someone is continually bringing negative comments around you, if they aren't productive with their comments, run, I mean run, away from them. Your enthusiasm is at stake. Then there's the people who we love and who love us and want to protect us. I mean, our mothers, our fathers, our uncles, our sometimes our wives and husbands. They'll say, you know, don't get too excited. Don't be so enthusiastic. It might not work out. They're saying it not because they're negative, but because they want to protect us from hurt. This is your opportunity to educate them. To tell them that life is filled with celebration and with hurts. But if we only focus on preventing the hurt, then we lose the opportunities to celebrate and be enthusiastic about life, to actually feel great. We take away our power and give the power to hurts when we focus on them. If we focus on the celebration and the excitement, then we deny ourselves. Or if we don't focus on the celebration and the excitement, then we deny ourselves of the health benefits and the positive aspects of feeling great and enthusiastic. I mean, really. Like good china, which I don't understand. Why do we reserve those for only special occasions? Actually, I don't. But why would anybody reserve the good china for a special occasion, which mainly only comes once a year? I mean, we should be sharing it all the time. I mean, really, aren't we worth the good stuff? So we want to educate our families and support people around us to not say, don't get so enthusiastic. On the contrary, get enthusiastic. And if it doesn't come, big deal. So move on to the next. That's what enthusiastic people do. Sometimes we just end up focusing on what didn't happen instead of what is happening or what is the next step. I mean, we are all human and we do all get disappointed sometimes. But we can easily fall into the drama of not getting the results that we wanted. Beware. This is very dangerous territory. Allow yourself to be disappointed, but return to smiling and laughing and acknowledging your accomplishments. I mean, you did take a risk, and that's a great thing to applaud. Every moment of our lives gives us a chance to either learn and applaud or to beat ourselves up and put ourselves down. I'd rather that we all choose to celebrate and learn. Choose to learn and applaud yourself and others. It's healthier, makes us happier, and definitely makes us more enthusiastic. All get disappointed. Are you listening to the itty pity pity party in your head? Are you feeling sorry for yourself? Feeling lonely? Feeling unloved or unwanted? Want some cuddling? I'm sorry, you're not going to get it from me. You are indulging in a pity party, and that's not a party I want you to attend, and I sure don't want to attend it. I mean, recently a friend of mine went through some bad parties. She was definitely in her itty-bitty pity party. She ended up having to declare bankruptcy. She was dealing with sick, ailing parents. She was not in a relationship, and she was feeling really lost. I mean, she was heading deep, deep into this itty-bitty pity party. She took out some coloring pencils, and she started to draw. It was something that she used to do as a kid, and we had had a discussion. She just said, I'm going to have fun. She drew and drew and drew. As she was drawing, she really knew she needed to get a job. So she put her drawings in a case. She headed to a local furniture store. She was hired, and now, 2 years later, she's a manager of the best-run, most profitable store in the chain. She has a gorgeous apartment looking over a beautiful lake. She has money in the bank and a supportive work environment. Every day she celebrates her staff and her good fortune. Does she have romance? Well, not yet, but it's coming. I know it is. She doesn't allow the itty-pitty party to enter her space, and when she does, she makes a phone call to get out of it. She gets busy and takes action. Won't you do the same? Enthusiasm is a skill. It's an art, and it requires practice and vigilance to make sure that you're always enthusiastic. I want you to have the results you deserve through your enthusiasm. So, let's go on and review some of the things that we studied. I'm so glad that I had the opportunity to share with you about enthusiasm. Enthusiasm takes your active awareness and your participation. It is a learned skill, and it is something that will transform your results in business, career, and life. You can be enthusiastic by using the strategies I outlined in this program. You know why enthusiasm is important. Beware when you're choosing not to experience and share enthusiasm. Know that enthusiasm does create results. Use the strategies I shared so you can be enthusiastic. And avoid the pitfalls I shared so that you don't lose your enthusiasm. I am dedicated to your potential. I'm dedicated to you and achieving the results, and I hope that this CD helped you become more enthusiastic. This is Pegine from Team Pegine, your all-access pass to your potential. Thank you for letting me share and be with you during this drive, this ride, and this talk. See you later.
For more products and information about Pegine and Team Pegine, please go to www.pegine.com. That's www.pegine.com. Or call 904-280-8806. That's 904-280-8806.